Published 0844, est, the 8th of November 2017, updated 1022, est, the 8th of November 2017, Britain's housing crisis was laid bare today as new figures reveal a third of men aged 20 to 34 still live at home with their parents. Women are more likely to move out, but a fifth the same age are still living in their childhood home, figures released today by the Office for National Statistics reveal. As house prices have soared over the past 20 years, the number of young adults living at home have also risen dramatically. In 1996, around 5.8 million 15 to 34-year-olds in the UK lived with their parents, and this has risen to 6.6 million this year. The figures will pile further pressure on Philip Hammond to find extra cash to try to ease the housing crisis in the budget in a fortnight's time. A third of men and a fifth of women aged 20 to 34 are still living at home with their parents, new figures have revealed. As house prices and rents have soared, so too has the rate of young adults still stuck in their childhood bedroom. Theresa May is said to have agreed with her chancellor to put house building at the heart of his economic plan. Many young people have given up on their dream of owning their own home, and the Prime Minister thinks getting them back on the housing ladder is crucial if she is to stand a chance of wooing young voters away from Jeremy Corbyn's Labour. In their statistical bulletin, The On said larger numbers of young adults tending to stay at home for longer may be explained by staying in education and training for longer, formalizing relationships and having children at older ages, and increased costs in renting or buying a home. Overall, the proportion of people aged 15 to 34 and still living at home with their parents has risen from 36% in 1996 to 40% in 2017. The number of 20 to 34-year-olds living at home has risen from 2.7 million in 1996 to 3.4 million this year. Labour's Shadow Housing Secretary John Healey said the figures showed the government has failed to do enough to tackle the housing crisis. He said the government are refusing to get a grip of the housing crisis, which has seen the number of low-cost homes to rent and buy falling to a 24-year low and private rents rising faster than earnings. The next Labour government will take action to ensure young people are able to have a place of their own by building 100,000 affordable homes to rent and buy a year and controlling rising private rents. Philip Hammond, pictured in Downing Street last week, is expected to make house building the central part of his budget when he unveils it to the House of Commons later this month. Over the past 20 years, house prices have risen by an average of 4.5% and over the past 40 years by an average of 6.8%, according to the Nationwide House Price Index, but in parts of Britain, particularly London and the South East, they have soared much higher, meaning many young people cannot afford to buy. While some young people choose to live at home for longer so they can save money to put together a deposit for a home, estate agents have predicted that the rise in interest rates will help cool the housing market, but it is still predicted to grow. In her speech to Conservative conference last month, Mrs. May announced an extra £2 billion for affordable housing, including the building of an extra 12,500 homes for social rent each year in 2020 and 2021, but housing experts have said the government needs to find far more money and set much more ambitious house building targets to cope with demand.